Deepfakes are no new technological invention, and just as they can be fun and entertaining, they can also be dangerous and catastrophic. Not only does the term deepfake take its root from the concept of deep learning, but the rise of AI coupled with the bloom of the digital era could also potentially result in the rise of deepfakes that can spell doom for our planet as a whole. With politicians and celebrities being at the top of the list of the world's most influential figures that creators of AI-enabled deepfakes impersonate, it appears that the world is in more trouble than anyone has ever predicted. Join us as we take a deep dive into why the AI content of deepfakes is one of the most powerful pieces of content in the world right now, and just how beneficial or catastrophic they can actually become. AI is increasingly becoming more powerful than human editing, and not long from now, not even the most experienced human editors would be capable of distinguishing fact from fiction. Since the 1990s, deepfake technology has been used in the film industry mainly for speech reconstruction. And even presently, deepfakes and other related AI content have been put into a lot of highly beneficial uses, as we'll come to reveal shortly. But away from the spotlight and all of the excitement surrounding deepfake technology, criminals in the US and across the world are now using this technology to apply for remote jobs to later gain access to company data. And going by available data, the cost of deepfake scams in the year 2020 alone was an estimated $250 million, and to make matters worse, there are presently no official laws regulating deepfakes. Voice cloning made headlines a few months ago after Amazon successfully tested the idea of Alexa conversing with the voice of a deceased loved one. And just earlier this year, a Holocaust educator was able to converse from behind the grave during her funeral earlier in June. Her pre-recorded info was expertly converted into a deepfake to mimic the normal flow of any typical conversation. While research remains ongoing in determining and combating the threat of deepfakes, it's now becoming even more glaring that this trend might become the norm a few years from now. The greatest fear and downside of this technology at the moment is that fraudsters may use it to their advantage. For context, they can use it to easily mimic voices to work in their favor by pretending to be a family member or an important personality. Now, there are increasing concerns that fabricated audio and visuals that are created using deepfake technology will birth the next rise in cybercrime. But deepfakes, primarily in social media, have now evolved and continue to be driven and powered by the sophistication of artificial intelligence, especially as they are now gradually expanding into the corporate sector. You see, in the push for greater digitalization, businesses and consumers alike have become much more dependent on technological platforms and gadgets in their day-to-day activities, mostly forgetting that the internet and the digital world are still an anonymous place and forcing several startups to begin to adopt a different approach to deepfakes. For instance, DeepTrace, a cybersecurity startup, estimated that the number of online deepfake videos has more than doubled, approaching around 15,000 in under a year. Likewise, TruePic, Microsoft's venture arm, is also concentrating on determining what is authentic about content at the moment it was captured rather than what is fake. Voice cloning, which remains a crucial part of deepfake technology, continues to have several practical applications across a wide range of industries. For context, voice cloning is frequently employed to enable those who have lost their voice to speak in their voice, as well as to enable content producers to use voice actors and shorten the amount of time that actors must dedicate to a project. Also, by utilizing a deepfake of their own reporter, news outlets may post news every day and all through the week without the actual reporter being present, saving the company a ton of time and money. Similarly, voice cloning is also increasingly being utilized for the production of digital entertainment content, such as video games or films, where the creators need to consistently produce audio content even when the actor is no longer available or if they died unexpectedly before the project was launched. In the film business likewise, deepfakes make it possible to have translated movies that feature the original cast members, given that the technology can change video and replicate voices. And not only do the voices sound like the original cast members, but the lip movements also perfectly match the words. But despite all of these benefits, criminals are also employing the same technology to produce more real-sounding and perfect impersonations. And despite all of the technological advancement in the world today, it's still very tough to tell who is on the other end of the call, and this continues to feed the surge in deepfake fraud against both organizations and individuals. Now as it stands, individuals most especially need to be aware that fraudsters are increasingly leveraging deepfake technology in stealing passwords, personal information, and even money by either attacking their bank accounts or contacting them directly with made-up identities. Although these growing threats aren't yet extensively in use, the prediction is that these criminals who hide behind the internet will progressively use them, so both individuals and businesses need to be careful and aware of them. To protect yourself or your business, you must be wary of calls or voicemails that appear to be from someone you know, especially if they're requesting personal information or money, and more especially if this seems out of character for that person. The government is also not safe from the possible harms that criminals have the potential of perpetrating using deepfakes and its deadly derivative of voice cloning. Governments globally are now increasingly wary that this technology can constitute a tool in the hands of opposition leaders and state-sponsored attackers in spreading misinformation over the internet. Using voicemail or a phone call, criminals or even terrorist organizations can mimic known associates and launch successful social engineering assaults. Additionally, voice cloning can be utilized to get around voice-based biometric systems when performing state-organized digital authentication. Where the cases are non-criminal, as with some of those already mentioned, there are currently growing concerns and issues regarding if content creators have the right to utilize another person's voice to create content that the voice owner never recorded. To put this in perspective, a director was recently caught up in a case similar to this in June 2021 after he used voice cloning to mention a phrase in the voice of the late Anthony Bourdain, which the actor never said. Without a doubt, and as these technologies develop, new concerns about the creator's rights to produce content using voice actors who might not have given explicit consent or who might not have been paid for using their voice will continue to surface. According to data collected by Cyber Magazine since 2019, it shows that hackers' interest in using deepfake technology has increased by a staggering 43%. And going by recent events in which deepfake technology has been used, it's also glaring to see that the technology is increasingly being used for harmful purposes. More recently, deepfake has been maliciously used in the ongoing Russia-Ukraine war. In March, barely a month into the war, a video showing the Ukrainian president ordering his army to surrender to Russian forces was shared on social media. Another recent incident involved a crypto project team that was duped into going to a meeting with a Binance executive under the pretense of getting their coins listed on the financial platform. The hackers accomplished this by taking the recordings of the specific executive that were readily available on social media, digitally altering the footage, and then using them to create an AI hologram. A cyber attack never takes place in a single phase. It often entails a string of reconnaissance techniques, such as knowing how to enter an organization's climate, steal data, and conceal your traces so that no one can catch you. One of the reasons deepfake assaults have grown in frequency over time is because AI technology, which is used to create deepfake films and audios, is developing at a far quicker rate than how quickly businesses are educating their staff to deal with the attacks. Because attackers are already creating video deepfakes by the time companies work out how to stop audio deepfake attacks, they are constantly one step behind. Another contributing factor is that many companies lack enough cybersecurity budgets and are unwilling to invest in the cybersecurity infrastructure and employees that are required to stay up with the rapidly advancing AI technology. Deepfake criminals only need to find an opportunity and take advantage of it right now. Elections and major conflicts are excellent opportunities for these characters to take advantage of deepfake media. Elections take place in every nation, therefore it's only a matter of time before even more sophisticated risks associated with this technology become widespread. Cybersecurity experts estimate that TruePic, Microsoft's product for video authentication, is only approximately 70% effective, even though it is doing well in combating deepfake assaults. To combat deepfake attacks, there is currently no technology that is 100% successful. This makes the best strategy for combating deepfake attacks at the moment being to try to understand what deepfake attacks are and how they operate. Another crucial thing to do in preventing attacks is to always remain vigilant. It is impossible to make the public unsee a deepfake video once they've already done so. Along with Microsoft's TruePic, other projects are under place that will use cryptography to identify deepfake content. Using this technique, every original video will have a form of crypto algorithm encoded into it so that if anyone tries to tamper with it, an alarm will immediately go off, making it possible for the criminal to be tracked down. Although it may be challenging, deepfake technology can still be defeated. To address this issue, organizations and governments will need to invest significantly more in cybersecurity, which is currently not happening. Deepfake technology has the potential to cause widespread harm, and this ought to be enough motivation that'll spur key stakeholders to step up efforts to fight it. A US law presently stipulates that anyone found producing deepfake content with the intent to harm a person or an entity may face jail time. But beyond rules, there should also be public awareness of the technology and its dangers, much like there were initiatives to enlighten the public and combat false information regarding COVID-19 and vaccines.